Welcome to this tutorial. This video will give you a comprehensive introduction to the Nextcloud interface. After logging in for the first time, you will see a welcome screen that also provides a brief introduction. Once you close it, you can see your dashboard at a glance. In my case, the default categories shown here are recommended files, talk mentions, and upcoming events. You can customize which categories you want to see here using the pencil icon at the bottom. It is also possible to install additional widgets from the App Store to further enhance the functionality of your Nextcloud. These newly installed applications can then also be displayed in the dashboard. You can also download many other applications from the App Store. These are sorted by category here on the left. You can find your active and disabled applications in this list above. For example, you can easily disable unwanted applications and customize your Nextcloud. Your profile is located in the top right corner. You can edit it, for example, add your personal information, upload a profile picture, or change the language of your profile. Under security, you can change your password or set additional login options. You can also customize the design of your Nextcloud under Appearance and Accessibility. This includes a dark design or a high contrast mode. You can also change the background of your cloud. Further customization options are available to administrators under Theming. For example, you can change the logo or enter your own legal disclaimer. You can also find these menus from the list by your profile. There you will also find the option to create additional users. To do so, click New Account and assign a name and a password. This new user can also be assigned to a group and you can give it a storage quota, but for example also unlimited. Click Add New Account to create the user. In the list, you can also see how much storage they are using, and by clicking on the pencil icon, you can edit all the details. On the right, you have the option to delete or disable the account. Next, we go to the Files item. By clicking on the desired file, you can view it, and by clicking on the three dots here, you can rename, download, and delete it. You can share the file with the icon to the left of it. This is also possible for entire folders. You can either enter a recipient directly at the top or share the link here. In the drop-down menu on the left, you can then specify which permissions should apply to this shared file. You can also set a password protection or an expiration date. If you want to upload files, you can either use this button here or simply drag and drop them to the desired location. If you want to delete a file or folder, you can either use the three dots at the bottom or select the files and delete them all at once. At the bottom, you will find your deleted files, where you can restore them or delete them permanently. The next menu item is Photos. This is where you can view, upload, and organize your pictures and videos. Under Add, you can create a new album, name it, add a location, and add people who can edit the album. You will then find this newly created album in the left menu under Albums. Here you can easily add all the photos and videos you want. You can either assign images that are already in your cloud or upload new images. You can download your photos by selecting them and clicking Download Selected Files. This is also where you can delete images. To share a single image, first open it and then click Open Sidebar. Here you will find Share and can either enter a person or share the link. To share a folder, just click the share icon in the folder. Under Activity, you will find a list of all processes in your cloud. For example, if files have been uploaded, changed, deleted, or if files have been downloaded via a link. This way you always know what is happening in your cloud and have a good overview of your files. The next item, Talk, is a chat program that you can use to write to other users as well as make phone and video calls. The default setting is a chat that only you have access to, so you can use it as a place for your own notes. To create a new chat, click the speech bubble at the top here and then click Create New Conversation. Then enter a name and optional description. You can also add a picture and allow guests to join through a link. In this case, you can also add password protection. Then click Add Participants and select the people you want to add. Then click on Create Conversation and you will see your newly created chat. Now all added participants can write messages, send files and voice messages, or start a call. An interesting feature is the option to be reminded of selected messages in the chat by clicking on Set Reminder. The three dots at the top also give you extensive setting options for this chat, and you can also delete it at the bottom. Here you will also find the link to the chat again for copying if you decided to do so when creating it. General settings for the entire Talk application can be found at the bottom left. Under Contacts, you will find an address book that already contains the Nextcloud users. You can create a new contact under New Contact and add all the desired information. Additional information, such as a birthday, can be added under Add More Info. Once the contact is created, it can still be edited and downloaded. Deleting it is also possible here. It is also possible to create contact groups to which all desired contacts can be assigned. Also to import contacts under Contact Settings in the lower left corner. You also have countless options in your Nextcloud calendar. To create a new event, click on Event at the top or click on the desired day. Then enter the title of the event, and if you have unchecked the All Day box, you can also enter the exact time. You can also add a location and a description. Clicking More Details gives you additional customization options. For example, you can add a reminder for the event or invite users under Attendees. To do this, you must have added an email address to your personal data. To delete an event, click the three dots at the top right corner. You can also create new calendars to manage different events. To do so, go to New Calendar and give it a name. The calendar can be shared with other users by clicking the pencil icon next to it. If you then check the Can Edit box for this user, you can share this calendar with them in full. When you create an event, you can change the type of calendar here. At the bottom left, under Calendar Settings, you can also import a calendar, such as a Google Calendar. If you have entered a birthday in your contacts, you can also activate the birthday calendar here and have it displayed. In the calendar settings, you will also find links to integrate the calendar on your smartphone or Mac. Looking for a secure Nextcloud hosting in Germany? Then choose Keyweb. Visit us on our website. We will be happy to advise you.